One of the biggest factors for electric vehicles is charging. Because after all, how are you supposed to drive an EV without having a charge? Tesla had gone ahead and built their supercharging network, making it easy for Tesla owners to get a quick charge in a reasonable amount of time. This, of course, is in addition to the ability to charge your car at home as well. Although that is at a much slower rate, but it is a good everyday option. But what if you are driving somewhere, you need to charge your Tesla, and there's no supercharging station nearby? Or what if you own a different EV from Volvo or Nissan or something and need to get a charge? What do you do then? Well, that's exactly when these independent EV charging companies come in, because that's the value that they provide. They have stations throughout the country, throughout the continent, throughout the world, where owners of different electric vehicles can come in, charge their car, typically for either a free or a very low rate. Now, if you've never owned an EV, then you probably have never really come across these, because they're kind of few and far between. They aren't all over the place just yet. But if you do own one, you've probably heard of companies like Blink, Flow, and ChargePoint. Today's focus is going to be on ChargePoint, because they announced a SPAC merger recently, and I want to discuss to see if this actually makes sense as a good option to get some good exposure to the EV market aside from Tesla. So anyways, guys, smash that like button down below, hit the subscribe button as well, and hit the bell notification so you're notified when I release any new video. So like I mentioned, ChargePoint is a company that builds out EV stations for charging, and so far they have delivered 82.4 million charges. Here we can see a high-level view of the value of ChargePoint and how they operate. They provide everything needed to offer a complete EV charging solution that can manage any Open Charge Point Protocol, OCPP, capable charging station, and integrate with other electric mobility apps and connected systems like Flow, for example, which is a common one. The simplicity to the end user, regardless of what station they're charging up at, is the fact that they can do payments via their smartphone, so it's extremely simple and straightforward as a consumer. Now, here are some more high-level points on why ChargePoint is a good company. And as a customer, they give you access to hundreds of thousands of places to charge with one single account. This means that in North America, you get access to 80% of AC charging and 99% of DC fast charging ports. These guys also have 60% of the Fortune 50 companies as customers. So if your office has a charging station and you work for a larger company, there's a good possibility that that was installed and possibly even delivered by ChargePoint. Now, the reason that ChargePoint all of a sudden is in the news here, you know, everyone's talking about it, it's popular on YouTube as well, is because, like I mentioned, they just announced a merger through a SPAC. Here we can see the chart of the SPAC that they're merging with, which has seen a nice bump in their stock price and goes by the ticker symbol SBE. So SBE, or Switchback Energy Acquisition Corp, is the SPAC that we're going to be talking about here that's merging with ChargePoint, and the deal is valued at $2.4 billion. The new combined company will continue to be led by President and CEO Pascal Romano and the existing management team. The new combined company will also be called ChargePoint Holdings Inc. and will be listed on the New York Stock Exchange. And that deal is expected to close sometime by the end of this year, so we should see this being created as a new combined company in Q4. Through this deal, ChargePoint will get an infusion through a PIPE to raise $225 million, giving them a new cash balance of $683 million. The cash will be used to do regular business stuff, including pay down debt that the company has. And the interesting thing that I caught here was that Bally Gifford is an investor here that's part of this deal. Now, Bally Gifford, if you're not familiar, is well known for being the largest investor in Tesla. They've made a decent amount of money on Tesla over the years and still remain bullish on Tesla to this day. It's very interesting for sure to see them bullish on ChargePoint as well, and I'd say they know a thing or two about EVs and all that kind of stuff, so this could very well be a good buying opportunity here if you're on the same wavelength as Bally Gifford. Even if ChargePoint plays out to be a fraction of the success story that Tesla is, that's going to result in some pretty significant gains. So all this looks exciting, and this is a business, guys, that has very good connections and customers already, from well-established names like 3M and Google to auto manufacturers as partners like BMW and Toyota. They seem to be growing very nicely, and since their product is broad-based across many manufacturers, it makes them kind of the go-to for consumers. Now, here's the thing. From an investor's perspective, like myself, it's really difficult to make a decision on whether this is actually worth worth an investment or not, because there isn't a whole lot of information released just yet on the full financial breakdown of ChargePoint. What we do know is that revenue in 2019 was about $42 million. But like we said, the company is going to be valued at around $2.4 billion, and this gives it a price to sales of 57. Now, you guys know if you follow the channel that I look for companies that have as low price to sales as possible, ideally under a 4, but usually I'll go up to like an 8 or a 10 if it's a really high growth business. But in this case, a 57 is just too far out of the realm of reasonable for me, which is why, based on this alone, I can't say that I'll probably be investing in this company, but I'll wait to see the full financial statement to see if there's something that I'm missing. Maybe there's a justification why it's so expensive. However, from what I've seen so far, doesn't look like that great of a value here. Also, recall from what I just discussed earlier, they have around $638 million in cash. So there is a good amount of cash on the balance sheet here. However, they do mention that they are going to be using some of that cash to pay down debt. Now, we don't know how much debt they have. Maybe it's a little bit, maybe it's a lot, but I want to see what that breakdown is. I want to see what the assets to liabilities ratio is for this company. And I want to see if they're actually in good financial standing before I can even go out there and say I'm considering buying some ChargePoint stock. Now, from a consumer's perspective, I have used the Flow charging stations a couple of times so far. And it's been a pretty straightforward experience, and I believe that they are powered by ChargePoint as well. So I would say the user experience, you know, it's straightforward, pretty simple. You can get a good amount of charge in a reasonable amount of time in an emergency typically, or if you're at your office, you know, you get a good amount of charge during the day. So there's no real issue from that aspect as far as I'm seeing right now. The sole thing that I really need to understand better and really need more clarity on is their financial breakdown. And I would strongly suggest that you guys, considering investing in ChargePoint for the long term as well, look for that information, wait for that information to make a decision on whether this actually makes sense as an investment. Now, if you're here to just gamble on this and kind of do short-term trades on this, there's probably a ton of other YouTube channels out there that cover this. This is probably not the channel for you. I don't really focus on short-term stuff. However, if you are interested in the long-term prospects for ChargePoint, I will most likely make a follow-up video if there's interest in that once those financials are released, once they're closer to merging, and that'll kind of give us a better idea of whether ChargePoint stock, this new merger, is actually worth buying. So like we said, we're probably gonna expect that merger sometime in Q4. No real date has been set yet. However, I do expect volatility to pick up quite a bit as we get closer to that date, so keep a close eye on that. But either way, guys, let me know in the comment section down below if you've been kind of dabbling in the stock. I know a few guys in my VIP group have been, and with these SPACs, there's a lot of money to be made. However, they are high risk, so just be careful with that. I wouldn't go all in with my life savings on this, but if you're smart, you can probably make some good money short term as well. Either way, guys, let me know in the comment section down below what you think of ChargePoint. Let me know what you think of this whole EV revolution that we're seeing right now with all of these SPAC EV companies going public. Love to hear your thoughts as always, but either way, guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to invest positively, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.